took some blows, got back up and told them demons on the feet. Yeah. Every time they count me out, I come back harder on the feet.
Is this really the end? Or is it a new beginning? A new reality?
Okay, so I haven't lost it, but I have been up for 2 days and emotionally drained and just inside my head and just really been meditating, and so I'm like kind of there. So as I walked up the steps, I'm really tired, but the lights are out. And as I come over here, like I'm seeing shadows and images, all the lights are out. And I'm looking, and I know I see my angels. Like, I know I see things that aren't, you know, there. So that's where Shana and Sharon's bathroom was. This is the room. Right at the door was this really big guy. Like, his shoulders were here. And, like, his head was up there. And when I looked, like, I seen him there. And I just stopped him, like, am I seeing things? Like, what am I seeing? And he had, like, this big black jacket on, and he was Diesel, like he was huge, he was huge. Like, I'm pretty big, and if I see him, I'd be like, whoa. But my intuition, he was my angel. And he was pointing me, like, I seen hands. I started like getting these visions, and I seen them pointing, but first it came up, and I was touching them, and I felt tingles, and once I went in here, this is Shane and Jerry's room. In the middle, I seen like it was a ring of people, and they were like dancing. And as I came over to here, as I walked by, I said hello, I looked down, my hands turned black. In the dark, I mean, it's already black, but my hands got extra dark, and I felt all the tingles. Like, now I know that I was feeling him. And now I was feeling an angel. And I can't hear anything, but I'm getting my intuition, my feelings, and this Diesel, very humble, very loving, but Diesel, protector, was my angel. And he was at the door, almost like allowing other people to come in or out. And everybody in here was dancing, and as soon as I walked in, I felt this energy of this heat of this, like, wow. And as I walked over, I stopped right here, and I seen this, there was somebody on the bed, and they were like really, they were pretty big and wide, but they had this hat. It was like this black hat, and it was all around. And I'm like, what am I seeing? And then all I can think of was like a shaman and like dancing, and they were dancing, like he was dancing on the bed. And I got closer. Look, I'm getting chilled now. As I got closer, it was just coming over me. It was like all these big, like, it was almost like these black peacock feathers. And I just felt all these vibrations, and I couldn't hear anything. But I definitely felt. So I got a little closer and I gave him a hug, and I felt all these tingles. Like, I'm still going like this, but I stopped and I can feel the tingles on my fingers. Like, I can feel it now. And whether I was seeing it, whether I wasn't seeing it, whatever, I was giving energy towards something positive. And whatever this awesome soul was showering me with, it was like a cleanse. And then it kind of stopped a little, and I walked over here, and I instantly felt my mom. I put out my hand, I just said, Ma! I felt her, And then I had a glimpse, I smelled her. And then I held her hand. And this isn't the first time that I've contacted my mom. And forgive my appearance, but it's been a rough couple days. But I held my mom again. And I felt the same way that she always held my hands. I felt the same energy in the same place, in the same strength, the same everything. Mama. And when I hugged my mom, I smelled her. I smelled my mom. And I thanked her. And you know, I told her that I'm doing all this for her, and all the energy goes to her. And I said, you know, whatever's left over goes to my angels, but you know, same, comes back to me and my angels anyway. I just put my mom first in line. And then I walk over here. I held my mom for a good 20, 25 minutes. Walked over here, went in the middle. And I just felt this awesome vibration. That light was like going all over. It was like the room was changing lights. I don't even know what was going on. I'm not having visions or just really tired or whatever, same or whatever. But I felt this incredible energy thanking me and cleansing me. And Janer and Sherry, I mean, today's been rough with them, you know, it's trying to get me like arrested and, you know, what that would do to Pop and, you know, like to do that to me after what I did for them, like that hurt. I love them both. I did everything for them. You know, they're strangers, and of course, you know, when you do that for strangers and you really don't know who they are, and, you know, their mom's a piece of shit. She's a drug addict and just left them with nothing. But it still hurts. It still hurts. But I felt like cleansed, like everybody gave me some love and energy because they knew what I did. They knew the genuine goodness from my heart and from Pop and, you know, what we did for them and everything that we gave them. And it was like we turned out to be the motherfuckers. And my angels and the karma and everything that happened today has been so perfecto tiempo. It's been such an amazing day. Stressed, but such an amazing day. And then I thought it was time for me to go. And I seen the big guy again. And I seen like his hands coming this way, and it was almost like pointing that way. And when I walked over, I seen his hand come out, like he was shaking my hand. And then I was still holding his hand, and something just told me to come here. And then it kind of changed, and there was somebody different. There was somebody smaller. And I instantly felt... I instantly felt Janer and Sherry's dad. And, like, genuinely thanking me for trying to help. And I apologized to them that I couldn't save them. I know their life's gonna be fucked up. I know it. And I tried. I really, really tried. Really, really, really tried. Really, really tried. But that's all you can do. Everybody has free choice and free will. But I would try again. And I thanked him for thinking of me for that opportunity. You know, because they have to choose who to give the opportunity to. Not everybody can try that. Not everybody's willing to do anything for that. You know, it has to be
somebody that has that type of energy and personality. And I was honored that they picked me to do it and, you know, set everything up. And their dad worked so hard, so hard. I know he gave a lot. He gave a lot. He had to sacrifice a lot on that end. He gave a lot for all these miracles and blessings, because they're huge. They're huge. And it didn't work out. And I know their destiny's fucked. I know it. They're both emotionally not well. They're nowhere near to. It hurts. I don't want to see people I love do that. I don't want to see anybody do that. But I know it. I know it's coming. I just don't want to see it. It hurts. So I kind of gave him a hug too. And then, the big guy, he was like pointing this way. And as I walked in, I seen this little boy over here. I was looking. And as soon as I ran around this corner, this black guy came out. And black guy, chocolate guy. And he was probably like maybe 20 years old and sweats. And he was just smiling, coming out, almost like, can you help me? Can you help me? He stuck out his hand and I'm like, I got you, fam. And I gave him a pound, gave him a hug. And I just seen a smile. Because I know they're, all my intuition came at that point, and they're here asking for help. They're here asking my angels and everybody else for help. And there's people need help everywhere. And all these people are other people's angels, and all these people are trying to help other people on that side. So they're asking my side connected to me, hey, can we set up the perfect tempo to make this stuff happen? So I accepted over there, and they came in here. There was like this hunchback kind of guy. He was like hunched over, and he was kind of shy. I just, you know, gave him some love, pat him on the back. And then I seen where these two were. It was two black boys, like two little kids. And he had, this was yellow and blue, and this was all like dark blue. And I seen their face, and this, he had like this big forehead and these certain eyes that I knew. And he was pointing down, and to the rug, in the dark, it was red. He kept on like trying to move it. And so I pick it up and move it, and it was like almost like I have to, somewhere in the future, I had to move this red rug. And it was like, it was a little bit like a design, but like very small lines. It was like red and blue, like the whole thing was like red and then like blue lines. And I know there's something where I have to dig and get that. And then there was a person standing on the side in the end. And to me from here, it was like, maybe like an 18-year-old girl, a little thick, like afro. But when I came over, I had to close the window a little bit, kind of disappeared. And then as I'm walking back this way, I just see this big giant guy. When I say big giant guy, this dude's like Incredible Hulk. And he's standing on that. I was like, whoa, you're big. And he was just like kind of smiling. Tapped there, I didn't feel him. Just tapped and then kept on going. And then when I came back out, came here, and I seen like two little dogs, like the size of a pillow. And what are they? Like, dogs? And I'm like, angel dogs? And I'm like, well, if Cupido has angels, and they're like angel, like dog spirits or something. I've seen two dogs the same size as Cupido. And so I called him over like Cupido. One came over, laid right down, just petting him. And the other one just walked slow over, called him over. They both like laid down, and I was just like, wow, wow. And then after that, I went back over here.
And I looked back in, and everybody was gone. Everybody's gone. So,
there's always logical reasons, and there's always spiritual reasons. Logically, very logically, I'm tired and I've been up for a while, and I'm stressed and I'm in my head and, you know, emotional and all over. Which, scientifically, psychologically, whatever, maybe I have visions, whatever the case is. But spiritually, it was the right moment at the right time in the right place with the right darkness for everybody to show me, for me to have that experience. And I've never had that experience. I never was able to see that clear for that long. And so many, I was like, wow, like, is everybody still here? Because they are. They're walking around or everywhere. You just can't see them. You just, you know. I was amazed because, you know, we're walking around there all the time and we don't think of that. So then I went over to my prayer altar with all the miracles. This is the bank. Philly shirt, got in Guatemala. Citizens Bank on the back. There's the door. Mason Bible, Ma, another Mommy Dukes with me. So then I put my hands on the Bibles and I asked everybody to come and pray with me. And just thank God and throw the blessings on the miracles, everything that we've done. You know, it's just a new chapter and I feel totally different today. Like, especially after all that, it was just, they gave me such a, like, a new sense of feeling, of purpose, of relief, of love, of the consolation, you know. It's almost like, you know, when you're hurting and the dog comes up and starts licking you and trying to make you feel better. Like, you know, I felt my angels knew how bad I was hurting and came in and gave me some love and reassured me. Hey, as long as we do what we gotta do, that's all that matters. Can't hit a home run every time. Sometimes you strike out. But you still swung the bat. You still tried. You still practiced for that. You still trained for it. You still did what you had to do. It just didn't happen. So, thank you, God. Thank you, angels. Thank you, Ma. Thank you, everybody. Love you.
You're going to change the way we used to be, and you're going to give us cities, and you're going to make us be a, you know, definitely a better person, better people. So, and besides that, I just seriously want to thanks to you, because if you were another person that you don't care about us, for example, in my case, you know that it wasn't necessary to take my hard for me, but I want can say that I had a, I always wanted before to meet you, like to meet somebody, like it's like in, okay, I never said that before, but like somebody is like, you know, like do things like you do, like yoga, exercise, or etc., etc., and had a good heart and do things that you do. I always want to meet somebody like that. So now I had the opportunity. I was thinking that I was wasting my time because I supposed to learn about you and study, or I mean study your thoughts, your personality.